Sahih Bukhari, Book 1, Revelation. Number 1. Narrated by Umar bin al-Khattab. I heard Allah's Apostle saying, "The reward of deeds depends upon the intentions, and every person will get the reward according to what he has intended." So, whoever emigrated for worldly benefits or for a woman to marry, his emigration was for what he emigrated for. Number 2. Narrated by Aisha, the mother of the faithful believers. Al-Harith bin Hisham asked Allah's Apostle, "O Allah's Apostle, how is the divine inspiration revealed to you?" Allah's Apostle replied, "Sometimes it is revealed like the ringing of a bell. This form of inspiration is the hardest of all, and then this state passes off after I have grasped what is inspired. Sometimes the angel comes in the form of a man and talks to me, and I grasp whatever he says." Aisha added, "Verily, I saw the Prophet being inspired divinely on a very cold day, and noticed the sweat dropping from his forehead as the inspiration was over." Number 3. Narrated by Aisha, the mother of the faithful believers. The commencement of the divine inspiration to Allah's Apostle was in the form of good dreams, which came true like bright daylight, and then the love of seclusion was bestowed upon him. He used to go in seclusion in the cave of Hira, where he used to worship Allah alone continuously for many days before his desire to see his family. He used to take with him the journey food for the stay and then come back to his wife Khadija to take his food likewise again, till suddenly the truth descended upon him while he was in the cave of Hira. The angel came to him and asked him to read. The Prophet replied, "I do not know how to read." The Prophet added, "The angel caught me forcefully and pressed me so hard that I could not bear it anymore. He then released me and again asked me to read, and I replied, 'I do not know how to read.' Thereupon, he caught me again and pressed me a second time till I could not bear it anymore. He then released me and again asked me to read, but again I replied, 'I do not know how to read, or what shall I read?' Thereupon, he caught me for the third time and pressed me and then released me and said, 'Read in the name of your Lord, who has created all that exists, has created man from a clot. Read, and your Lord is most generous.' Then Allah's Apostle returned with the inspiration and with his heart beating severely. Then he went to Khadija bint Khuwaylid and said, 'Cover me, cover me.' They covered him till his fear was over, and after that he told her everything that had happened and said, 'I fear that something may happen to me.' Khadija replied, 'Never. By Allah, Allah will never disgrace you. You keep good relations with your kith and kin, help the poor and the destitute, serve your guests generously, and assist the deserving calamity-afflicted ones.'" Khadija then accompanied him to her cousin Waraka bin Nawfal bin Asad bin Abdul Uzza, who during the pre-Islamic period became a Christian and used to write the writing with Hebrew letters. He would write from the gospel in Hebrew as much as Allah wished him to write. He was an old man and had lost his eyesight. Khadija said to Waraka, "Listen to the story of your nephew, O my cousin." Waraka asked, "O my nephew, what have you seen?" Allah's Apostle described whatever he had seen. Waraka said, "This is the same one who keeps the secrets, Angel Gabriel, whom Allah had sent to Moses. I wish I were young and could live up to the time when your people would turn you out." Allah's Apostle asked, "Will they drive me out?" Waraka replied in the affirmative and said, "Anyone, man, who came with something similar to what you have brought was treated with hostility, and if I should remain alive till the day when you will be turned out, then I would support you strongly." But after a few days, Waraka died, and the divine inspiration was also paused for a while. Narrated Jabir bin Abdullah al-Ansari, while talking about the period of pause in revelation, reporting the speech of the Prophet, "While I was walking, all of a sudden I heard a voice from the sky. I looked up and saw the same angel who had visited me at the cave of Hira, sitting on a chair between the sky and the earth. I got afraid of him and came back home and said, 'Wrap me in blankets.' And then Allah revealed the following holy verses of the Qur'an: 'O you, Muhammad, wrapped up in garments, arise and warn the people against Allah's punishment, up to and desert the idols. After this, the revelation started coming strongly, frequently, and regularly.